Hello guys, this is Bilal Khan. You are watching Simplified Coding and we are learning Android application development with Kotlin. So we learned how to create a very simple list view, and in the list view that we created in the previous video was a very simple list view that was containing only a single item at each position of the list view. Now in this video, you will learn how you can customize your list view item. So you might want that you want to show an image view and a text for each item of the list view. So how to do this? We will see in this video. So let's start. Here I have a new blank project. You see, hello world, I have created this project using an empty activity. So you also create a new project. And then first we will delete this hello world. So delete it. Now we will drag a list view here. So just select a list view. So we have this list view here, and we will give the list view an ID. So let's put list view. You can actually give any ID, that doesn't matter. So we have a list view. Now we want an image and a text for each item of this list view. So I already have some images here. You can use any image that you want, but make sure the names of your image files should be in smaller cases. So you see here, every file name is in a small case, and you can put an underscore but no spaces and no special characters. So remember that. You can only use small cases for the file names, and only underscore, no spaces and no underscores are allowed. So make sure renaming your file if the file name is not following the rules. Now once you copy the image files, come inside app, then res, and then this drawable folder. Everything that can be drawn on the screen like an image, we paste it inside this drawable folder, or you can say we store it inside this drawable folder. So just right click here and paste and hit OK. You see we have all the images. Now we can use these images. So for our list view item, first we will create a class. So we will create a new Kotlin class, let's say hero. So we have class hero, and for now we are having only two items for our hero. One is image and one is name. So we will write here val image, and it is an int, and val name, and it is a string. So we have our class hero that is having an image as int and a name as string. Now you may ask that why images and int? Because each of these images that we pasted here has a unique ID, and it is an integer, and we can refer to the images using that integer. So that is why name image is an int here. So we have image as int and name as string. So that's it for the hero class. Now we will create a layout file. So to create a layout file, come inside the layout folder and create a new layout file here. So we will select a layout resource file. Now give it a name. And I will create a relative layout. Now, if you don't know what is a relative layout, then don't worry. We will cover all these things in the further videos. So for now, just assume this is a layout where we can put views. So you can give it any name. So I will give here my list item. That's it. Now, in this layout file, we will design the items of our list view. So, I already said that we will be having an image view and a text view. So, search image view here. and you can select any image from here for your image view, and we will change the image view on runtime. So you can choose any image. So let's select this nice Android icon. So we have this image view, and you can change the width and height actually. So for now let's make it 200 dp and 200 dp, and then we will have a name. So I guess the size is very large, so I will make it 150. So we have the image view. Then we will drag a text view. So drag a text view here. Nice text view. Now you can change the text size. Where is the size? Search size. So this is the text size, and you can change it to any size that you want. So we have an image view and a text view. Now this is it for our list view items. Now we will create a custom adapter class using array adapter. So again, come to your package, right click, new, then select Kotlin file class. Now here we will write the class name, and I will select a class here, and you can give any name. So here I am giving my list adapter. That's it. Now we will create a constructor here, and we will pass some values. So to create a list, we need var context, and it would be a context. Then we will need this layout resource file, and again it is an integer. Each resource is identified by a unique integer that is automatically generated. So we will write here var resource as int. Now the last thing is the very important thing actually, and this is the list items. So for the list items, we will use a list of, so we'll write here var items as list. So we have list of type hero. That's it. So we have list items, the list item layout file, and the context. Now one more thing we need to do here, so I will just break it so that you can see it in one screen. So this is our constructor. Now as we are creating a adapter class, we need to extend array adapter, and the type of this array adapter would be our hero class. So we need to define the type for our array adapter, and in this case the type would be hero. Now we will call the constructor of this array adapter class, and we will pass context, resource, and our items. That's it. What's wrong here? Some name issue, so change the name. That's it. So we created a class, then we have the constructor containing these values, context, resource, and items. Then we extended or inherited the array adapter class, and we called the constructor of this array adapter class, and we passed the values. That's it. Now what we will do here, we will create, we will override a method. So to override a method in a class, just right click, go to generate, and select override methods. Now here we will override the method get view. You see, this is the method that we need to override. So we have the method. Now in this method we will inflate this layout. Now you may be confused what is inflating the layout. Now inflating a layout means we are creating the Kotlin objects using XML resources. Now this process is called inflating. So to do this we will create a layout inflator object. So we will write here layout inflator as layout inflator, put a var here, var layout inflator as layout inflator and equals to layout inflator dot from. Now here we need to pass the context, and you know we already have the context here, so we will pass mctx, that's it. Now from this layout inflator object we will inflate our list layout, which is my list item here. So just right here we will create a view, so we will write val, and we can use val for this as well as we are not going to change the layout inflator. So if you don't want to change the objects later, define it as val. So here we will create a view, so we'll write view, and the type of this view would be view equals to, now we will use the layout inflator object, so write layout inflator dot inflate. Now the first parameter is the resource that we want to inflate, and the resource ID is here in this resource variable. So we will write resource, that's it. And the second parameter can be null. It is actually root, so root is null for our resource. That's it. So we have the view. Now from this view we will get these views, these image view, this image view and this text view. So come back to the adapter class, and here we will write val image view as image view equals to view dot find view by ID and then r dot ID dot image view, that's it. Import image view. If you are seeing the red sign, then put the cursor here and press alt and enter, and it will give you the option to import the package. So select it and it will import image view, and the error is gone. Now the same way we will create a text view equals to view dot find view by ID r dot ID dot text view. That's it. Now from this position, this is the position that is defining the current item of the position in the list. So from this position we can get the current item from this list, and we can use this item to get the values, the image and the name. And we will set that image and the name to these views. So just write here val hero as hero, capital hero, and it is equals to items dot get, or we can simply write items index position. That's it. We are using this position. So we have the hero here. Now we will use this hero object to get the values that we need to set in these views. So first we will set the image view. So we will write image view dot set image bitmap or image drawable, and here we will pass mctx dot cat.resources and .getDrawable. That's it. Now in this getDrawable, we will pass the drawable ID that we want to set. And we have the drawable ID inside this hero object. So we'll write hero dot image. That's it. Now we will use the same for this text view dot text equals to hero dot name. And then we will return the view. So this method getView is returning the view of the list item. You see, the return type of this method is view. So that's it for the adapter class. Now just come inside this main activity, and here again we will create a late init. So we'll write late init where list view as list view. That's it. Now we will initialize this list view, and to initialize the list view we will write list view equals to find view by id r dot id dot list view. That's it. Now we will create a list containing our list items. So for this we will write here where list of type list, and or we can simply write it like list equals to mu table list of, and we will define the type as hero. That's it. Then we will add our list items in the list. So here we are using static items, and we will add the items as add, and we will pass hero object. So for the hero object we need to pass the image ID and the name. So we will start with Batman. So just write here r dot drawable dot Batman and then the name. So we have name as Batman, and we will do the same for all the images. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 images. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Just change the values. So let me do it quickly. That's it. We have all the items in the list that we want. Now we will create our adapter object. So we will create here val adapter of type my list adapter, and it is equals to my list adapter, and we will pass context. So we can pass this, then the resource which is my list item. So we will write r dot layout dot my list item, and then our list items which is list. So right here list. That's it. Now we will simply write list view dot adapter equals to adapter. That's it. Actually we don't need to define the adapter type here, as we are directly creating the object. So this should work. So let's try running our application. So you see here we have our nice list view. Some problem with the design. I guess we need to set the constraint. So one more thing I would like to tell you in this video, as don't use constraint layout for now, as we are beginner, so we should not use constraint layout. So just delete this constraint layout and change it with, let's say, relative layout. And I will explain relative layout and all the other layouts in the coming videos. So for this we have this relative layout, and delete everything and just define width and height. So width is match parent and height is match parent. That's it. So for now, we will do this way. And later we will learn about the constraint layout and all the other available layouts. So let's run our application again. So we have this nice list view. You see? Now let me tell you again that what we did in this video. So first thing, we created this list view. We used this list view from this palette and we dragged it to our screen and we set an ID to our list view. Then we created the layout for items of our list view. And in this case, we have an image view and a text view. Then we created a data model class to store the values of our list item. Then we created a custom adapter class. And for the constructor of this class, we are having the context. Actually, we can use val here as we are not changing the values. So we should use val. So we have context here, then the resource of this layout file, our list item here, then the actual list items as a list of type hero. And then we extended or inherited the class ArrayAdapter in this ListAdapter class, and the type of the ArrayAdapter is hero. Then we pass these values to the constructor of this ArrayAdapter class. So we have context, resource and items. Then we overrided this method, and this method is returning as the view of our list items. So in this method we created a layout inflator object to inflate layout, to inflate views from this my list item, this XML file. Then we created the view by inflating this layout. And then from this view, we got the image view and text view. Then we got the hero of specified index using this position variable. And then we used this hero object to set the image and the name. And then we return the view. Now inside main activity, we create a simple list view. Then we get the list view from XML. And then we created a list of type hero. It is a mutable list as we want to add the items later. And then we added all the items that we want for our list view. And then we created an adapter object passing the context, the layout and the list items. And then we set the adapter to our list view. And our list view is working fine. So this is it for this video, guys. If things are getting out of your head, don't worry, please do comment and I will try to help you. And if you found this video helpful, please hit on the like button, subscribe to my channel, and please share this video, and I will see you in the next video. Thanks for watching, guys. See you.